Welcome to No Man's Sky Survival Mode. Now, in the last part, I managed to get myself killed twice, once on a planet and once out in space. The one in space was just total stupidity, and what it actually did is it wiped out my complete inventory. And anyone of you following this series will realize that there's been a bit of a gap in the recordings, and the reason for that is that I've had to take time out to start to recover some resources in order to get out and be able to continue the game, really. But what I've also done is I've actually installed some survival support for my hazard protection because I was on a toxic planet and it was just taking ages. I had to keep stopping and all that, so I've decided to get a bit of extra support. What I have done though is I went to a planet and some hostiles there, and we killed some more. I killed quite a few animals, and I've got 134 mordite. And I thought, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by planting some, putting some plants in. I think this is mordite, yeah. And what I'm going to do is I don't really have the necessary formula or for anything that what this is actually used for. I think it's adhesive. I was watching somebody else's channel the other day, and they were growing it to produce adhesive, which is supposed to be a very good source of income. So I thought, well, maybe I'll get some down here, I'll start harvesting it, and maybe when I actually get that formula, I'll be able to get in and make some cash. So, and I've just harvested those because we're going to go out and explore. We're going to carry on the quest for Rigogen because that seems to be the way forward, and I really want to get a ship. Oh, can't in here, so we need to be nice if you could transfer to the. And what I'm going to do is put the Antrium and the Mordite in here, and we're going to go out and explore because the focus still remains finding Rigogen, getting a new ship with the cash. And you can see here, I've kind of spent quite a lot of cash in order to rebuild. And what we're going to do is go back to the teleport to the system where I'm currently exploring. You can see Kwang Tong Tongzi Station. It's not the system where I died in. I got a bit depressed with that, so I've moved on to a new system. I kind of did a hyperdrive. I'd really like to get a ship that as a warp drive enhancement, so I can get to other planets besides G-type planets, because I'll get a. I think there'd be a bit more flexibility then. So, don't think I've raided these already. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up and sell. Oops, gone the wrong way already. Look at that, that's an inspiring start. I think this way. I'm going to go and sell off the Venom Sacks and Gravitino Ball, get a bit of cash. And then we're going to go out exploring, looking for Rigogen and other bits and pieces, and try not to get killed. So I'll see you in a minute, guys, once I've gone up and done the business up here. All right, guys, I've been chopping and I actually bought some suspension fluid. I think I've tapped this system out very much. There's not a lot here, and there's not much chance of Rigogen. They're all dry planets, so I thought let's go find a new system, something new that might be a few planets on. That's got three planets. Maybe the path to the center of the universe. See what that's got. That's got five. Okay, let's go here. Domidia boundary. Yeah, I think this is a new start. Well, a new start in recording, so let's celebrate it by going to a new planet. And of course, we fly straight into a space battle. Great. No, it's got here. And of course, I can't scan anything. Let's fly this way. I can't do a pulse engine. I get the feeling sometimes this game's working against it. Even my scanner's not telling me what I want. Planet base detected. What's over there? Mr. Van Rostel. That's for Revium. That's a good thing with the space battle going on. That's Terenium. And what have you got for me? Ganner is recharging. Condensium. I think we'll go for condensium first and see what that is. I think I need lots of all these resources. But of course the big one we want is Rigogen. So we're just going to put down on this planet. Basin Avalovo. Looks pretty barren. And of course what we're going to do is we're going to go for the usual routine, guys. Oh, there's a few plants here because one thing I do need to stock up on is carbon. Something on that planet had a big downside. It's the one element that's doesn't have a lot of, and that's carbon. So right, I'm going to fly across the surface. I'm going to find a base because new system, new planet. We've got to be able to have somewhere to land. Maybe it doesn't have a landing post, but I think we're going to land on it anyway. So, I mean, I can always use a bypass chip if it doesn't. So, no, it's just two simple bases, but that's okay. See what type of planet we're on. Oh, HOTS. It hasn't told me what the planet is. Reactive, limited, flora limited, infrequent. Right, so we got a radioactive planet. I've got the protection. So we can go out and explore. Certainly want some carbon. Got some chrysonite. I'm certainly going to grab that. Let's just check out these places and grab the base for our... Claim it for the, I won't say Empire. Max Convergence Cube. One more step on our journey to the centre of the universe, because I do want to get to the centre of the universe. Or galaxy. Maybe actually end the journey. So. Beam Coolant Sigma. Oh well. Nothing else in here. So, some creatures over there. So you see, I've got the shield here, which is good, but you've still got to be a bit aware that when that shield runs out, you've got to be able to recharge it. There's some plutonium over there. Let's go this way. Right, a scan. Got a thamium over there, we've got a resource there, we've got plutonium over there, so... Oh, and we've got a rare mineral here, let's go and check out, this should be, I think it was, what was it, cadencium? So, yeah, this is these little plants. Planet with the little plants. Go down here and... Certainly need to grab some carbon. Yes, I know. Because my shield, my protective shield has actually run out now. So we're back to normal business. Check out those spire things. Nope, not close enough. Ah, really nice wadge of plutonium. That's exactly what I want. That alone makes it worth landing here. I think we can shielding shard in. I'll just go round and investigate. Plenty of plutonium here. We'll grab a bit of iron so we can recharge the pulse engines. bit of antrium. Yeah, I must admit, I was very depressed. I mean, you guys probably had a good laugh at me for doing that stupid, stupid thing. I mean, I should never attack that ship. Oh, looks like we got some emerald here in a basin. Okay, send the Corvax cube back. I think what we'll do is a kind of trick now, guys. You blast your way into the emerald and get into the emerald here. Then you can kind of just sit in here and mine the emerald out. I mean, if you played the pre-foundation game, you would be familiar with what I'm doing. I think I'll use some thamium. Just used all my carbon up. Just gonna mine out some emerald just to make a bit of cash. I'll see you guys in a minute. Right, guys, I decided to do a bit of a push to get that plutonium, and then we're going to get out of here. So grab that carbon, grab this nice big wadge of plutonium, and then we'll make a dash back to the ship. And the ship's that way, so get moving. I think we can afford to run. It's a bit of a drop here, but oh Christ, what's happened? Where am I? Fallen back down the very hole that I created. Okay. Get some antrium. Because that's what you do. We're going to make it. We're going to make it, guys. Don't worry. Protection. I'm not going to go for the ship. I'm going to go for the hut. Come on, come on. Incoming storm. Storm. Great. We've got a radiation storm. But we've made it. Wow. Seriously, I don't think there's much on this planet, really, to be. I mean, we've got a bit of cadencium, but I think that doesn't forward my quest. We've made plenty of emerald, but, well, I think what we're going to do is skip back to the space station and, well, let's do a bit of bit of research on the way through. Plenty of plutonium now, so let's go looking for a space station. Nah, sorry. Got two nice bases over there, but what we got over there then? Got a trading post. Okay. Let's go for the trading post on this planet. 38 seconds, 36, 35, 31. They're not starting to scare me yet. Well, we're getting into the safe zone now. We've got 27 seconds to go. I think if we go and land on this trading post, sell off the emerald, then we can check this planet out and see if that's got anything of any value. And we may eventually find some Rigogen. So, if not, our quest carries on. I think I'll also look for the necessary resources to get another hyperdrive. I think this is going to be the question. So we're just going to have to keep moving. Check out all five planets in this system. So, here we go. It's interesting the way the ship just rotates. Bugger. Whoops, a daisy. There we are. Kind of puce off colour. High security, alkaline rain, poisonous planet. Wow, this is going to be interesting. Do I really want to hang around on extreme sentinel planet? Well, first thing we're going to do is sell off what we've got. Much. But we'll get rid of that. And we'll get 143,000 for that. We can buy some electron vapor. No, they've just got suspension fluid. Nearly made a mistake there, guys. What we're going to do is... don't know what he wanted, but because we've got an Atlas pass, we should be able to get some electron vapor or suspension fluid for free from here. Yep, you've got electron vapor. Suspension fluid. Right. Got a keen dagger. I've already picked up two of those, and I've got them stashed back in my storage vault, so I don't think I need any more. Are there any more up here? Well, because we've got the toxic protection. In here, okay, there's only more goodie stacks here. Yeah, look at that. Yep, we're okay, guys. We're okay. Lots of Vakine hanging around here. We can sell all that. Let's go and sell off our booty. And of course, what we're going to do is see if we can buy some. Certainly going to buy. I don't think that carbon. Certainly going to buy some carbon, but it's going to be perpetually short of carbon. We're certainly going to buy the plutonium. And right, let's make some more fuel. Oops, cell fuel, antimatter. Right. Antimatter. I'm sure in the vanilla game you could stand here and... so how we got now? Got suspension fluid, got plutonium, very short carbon. Really, really need a cold planet. Where's my ship? Lionsome. Special relationship. I am an armorer. No, nope, don't need an armorer. A lot of these guys stood around, but they don't talk to you. I'm hoping that these are like precursors for something else that comes in the game. I'm an armorer, so we've got two armorers. Okay, gotta have an arm. You're having an armorer's convention. Okay, thank you very much. So, I don't think I really want to mess about on this toxic planet because it's pretty dry, so I think this is a bit of a waste of time as well. So I think we'll get up into space, make sure our pulse drive is fully charged. And anything else here? What have we got over here? Gigaboo Dude Emerald. You've got Terrarium, Densium. Okay, let's go for that one. It just wonder if it's got water on and it doesn't have a rare element, then it may not actually there. This is going to be a bit of a. If we get bounced, which we are going to get bounced, right? I'm going to show you guys a very very quick dodge, which is why I carry a warp sail. What you do is you go like this, and you actually warp out of the planet. System. That's two planets. We don't want that. Two planets. Okay. Three exploration. Backspace. What have we got here? Three planets. Great. Backspace. Anything else here? Planets. Let's say we've already discovered that one. We got here four planets, two moons. Oh yeah, we're certainly gonna go here. The Magsipasang cluster. And that's how you get away with it, guys. Sneaky escape. And we got a space anomaly here, so we'll go and say hello to Nada and Polo. Key milestone accomplished. I've warped 30 times. Wow. Okay, the stations. Where's the station then? It can look stop. No. 35 seconds. Okay, let's scan the planet. Anomaly detected. Yes, we'll get round to that. Okay. Again, here's another little quick dodge. Hang around the entrance. Just to get rid of the scan. And once they... Then you just fly into the ship and it cancels the scan. It says a hostile subspace scan failed. And that, guys, is how you dodge pirates. And I'm gonna stay here, guys. We're gonna go back out into space. Got a save point. We've dodged this hostile scan. Let's start. Thank you guys for blinding me. I always wanted to be blinded. Right, let's see if we can check some of these planets out. That's got Cadencium on it. Who's got the tower? Transmission tower. Let's go for the transmission tower. We may find a crash ship. Try anything once. Oh, why are we? Oh, we're flying round the planet. I was starting to wonder where we were going. No, we're actually going to another planet. Wow, or a moon. Oh, this could be cool. Oh, it looks like there's a blue planet over there. Wait, it looks like we might be making progress here, guys. We're still going to check out the transmission tower here. It should give us a safe landing point. Looks like we've got another. We get a free landing here. Radiated winds, regular, bountiful, scarce. Right. At least we should be able to stock up on some carbon here. Yeah, this is a moon. That explains why I could fly around it. Yep, a radiated planet. Oh. Okay, drop a save. And of course, we're going to grab some. Got a Geck charm. Gonna grab some carbon because I need to be able to recharge my multi-tool. Yes, I know. Sounds like the this is the Geck system. There we got bolt caster clip. All credits gratefully received. Okay, get in the transmission tower. Yep, hello, Mr. Geck. Geck Trader, Rosie dot Hiblip. Yeah, well. Various points to the elements I've mined and also looks concerned, accusing that it's a packet of gas that smells trouble. Reassure with mining beam. I am convinced the trader that I am to be trusted. He's highly relieved. Jetpack booster Sigma. Oh, that could be useful. Course, we're gonna grab the carbon. Right. Faint, insistent bleeping noise comes. A garbled distress call can be heard. So 2 4s, 3 4s are 12. 4 4s, 4 12s are 48. 5 6 4s, 24. I think it's 1 4 40. Yep. So we've got a crash ship. We're going to go and check that out. Standing with the callbacks. So we spoke to a Gex. But our callback standing has actually improved. Oh well, interesting. Now I need to check because I don't think I've got any iridium. Oh, we've got 90, that's nowhere near enough, so I think there's a iridium deposit over there. I think this game's got itself a little bit confused because that was a callback's voice on a thing. So what we're going to do is go over here and get some iridium, stock up on some, because if we're going to repair the ship we need iridium and carbon. So let's grab that, and of course the radiation's going down, so just kind of run over here, make sure we don't fall down the crevasse. Yes, I know. And of course, what we're going to do is the usual thing where kind of tunnel underneath it. And that should give us a little bit of protection while we actually mine it. And again, maybe not. But one thing about iridium, it goes down very, very quickly. what I'm going to do is I can got some technology here that's going to be useful. I wonder if I can blast into the base of one of these things. What I can do is stand here and mine out the rest of the iridium. Maybe get a little bit more. Get some carbon and some iron. 500 iridium should be enough to repair the ship if it's any good. And I think we can restock that. It's going to use up a lot of our life support. A bit low on thamium, although I think I've got thamium inside of my ship. So grab some more iron on the way through. It looks like there's plenty of iron on this planet anyway, so I don't think I need to worry too much about some plutonium. Grab that. Really, really need the carbon. I think it's time we can get back to the ship. It looks like there's quite a lot around anyway, so let's get back to the ship and I'll try and avoid falling down the hole this time. That iron or carbon. That's carbon. Let's run around this way. Got that ready. Is there another base here? I check this one out. Yeah, we've done that one. Oh, maybe I misheard. Maybe it was a Gek. Gek with a sore throat. Right, I think I've got enough to go and check this crash ship out. So, and before we do this, right, you've got iridium, you've got plutonium, we've got chrysonite. And do that. We're going to take off. Find the crash ship, which is over this way. Not far away, could have even walked to it. Although walking is a relative concept in this game. So. Build jetpack booster. Yes, I know. But survival mode does not encourage you to use your jetpack unless it's absolutely necessary. So I don't think I could have walked this distance. Let's have a look at what's on the ground. Looks like it's doesn't look too bad actually. Now let's. Oh, come on, let me land, please. Okay. I can see you. Grab that. A little bit stubby for me. A bit reminiscent of a flying brick, but 19 slots. 18 slots. Oh, No, I thought it had an extra hyperdrive. Is it worth it? Is it? I'd lose the plutonium that I've loaded into my thrusters. Okay, let's go for it, guys. But what I will do first is get some resources out of here. That's everything we can do. I'm committed now. Certainly gonna to the Heridium, Ryzonite, iron. The aluminium would be useful. Cadmium would certainly be useful. I think we can leave the plutonium behind. Okay, here we go. I know it's only one slot, but and now we've got a broken ship. And everything fill up right now. What I've got to do now is probably get rid of the Gek charm because it's not worth that much anyway. And got to remember now, long time since I've done this actually, guys. I used to do this routinely. So, pulse engine, we need 4 Carlite sheets. Thrusters, we need 7 Carlite sheets. I think we'll do the. And the hyperdrive, we need a dynamic resonator, which means we're going to have to go to the space station. So we need 7 Carlite sheets, right? Done. Actually, this is going to be a bit tedious to. Actually, what I could do is do that. Send that to the ship. That will repair the pulse drive, and that would give us a bit more space here. And then the next step is we need 7 Carlite sheets, which means we'll probably have to go out and oops. You can see now why I collected quite a lot of iron before I started this. Because it does take a lot of iron and iridium, especially when you get a more advanced ship. So how many have we got now? 5, 6, 7. So we'll repair the launch thrusters. And we're certainly going to top them up. Fields are okay. I haven't got that annoying buzzing sound. You filled the pulse engines up. That was relatively painless. You can pair that 50 aluminium advanced cooling sigma. I think we can live without that for the moment. I think we can repair that and repair that. Could have done with that actually. Got to be a bit careful. So we've got that repaired. How am I doing for resources? I think we're scout round here now. And see what we can pick up round here before we leave. We're right in the middle of a storm, so. Grab that. Back into the ship. Let's see what we've got. We've got one micro density, but we've got not enough thamium. I don't want to use up all my thamium just on repairing this ship. So, just gonna sit in here for a little while. I've loaded up a shielding plate, so. Bye bye. Good old trusty ship got blown up in several times. Get some carbon. What we're going to do is just explore this bit. I think this, I'll just explore this area and then that'll be the end of this video. I'm going to try and keep them short, guys, for obvious reasons. Because obviously this can get quite boring, even a little bit tedious. So, grab some carbon. Falling. Like we got some. Run over this way. We can click this. I can do that on the way back. Or when I found there's plenty of iridium on this planet. About that. Okay. Sure, there was some condensium around here. There's these little plants, that's the problem. Yeah, I know, we'll be okay. Platinum. Go and grab a bit more. I have a bit of a platinum fixation. Back in the ship. I think this is where I'm going to leave it, guys. As I say, I want to keep these short. We've now got a new ship. I will finish off exploring this area off camera and then we'll pick up the story on the next part as we go looking for Rigogen. And the good thing is we didn't pay anything for this ship, so even though it was only a one slot increase, I think it will kind of give us benefits eventually. So on that note, guys, hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time, whatever you do, enjoy your gaming.